2020 opening day is here. Finally. We thought it was going to be quite a while ago, but with the Nationals, Yankees, going to be facing off just after midnight here, so to celebrate, we're finally going to open these opening day cards. It's a double blaster box, and they came together, so I think I'm going to get both of these open, might even open the packs up as well, save a bit of time, and we'll have a look and see what we might be able to pull. So I've opened up all of those packs, and let's see what we've got within. So Nats, I'm sure Doolittle will be hoping to close out that first game of the season. Go back. Rodriguez, Stroman, Yates. There we go, Munoz. I'll set aside these rookie cards, even though obviously they are opening day, so not such a big deal. Alcantara is the opening day start for the Marlins at the Phillies. So, I mean, it's a great opportunity for guys like him who, you know, have been trying to push as starting pitchers and trying to make their way through. Well, it's usually a slow start to the season for the hitters. Apart from guys like Josh Bell, he had an amazing start first half to last season. So we'll kind of have to see, because he could really benefit from something like this if he has the same kind of season. Our first mascot card. I'm a big fan of the mascot cards. I think they're a lot of fun. Max Kepler, our German friend, De Jong, Ozzie Albies, LeMahieu, and Contreras. And then we got Bo Bichette. Our first Spring Has Sprung. I really like this Spring Has Sprung set. I think it's very, very cool. I'll pop him to one side as well. Marte. Let's see. Jorge Soler. I'm sure he's hoping to lead the AL in home runs again. Nick Solak, rookie card. Forget, because these are the guys who are in the Series 1 checklist. So Abraham Toro. I don't think I actually pulled Abraham Toro last time, so that's a cool guy. Yeah, guys that were from the Series 1 checklist, so we're maybe haven't seen them for a little while. Zach Gallen. So, Texas Rangers. Yelich. So the Brewers are playing at the Cubs to start the season, and they say we'll see him pretty soon. Jack Flaherty, he's got the start as well. Yeah, he's got the start over there against the Pirates, against Musgrove, I think it was. And the same for Kershaw, he's going to be starting against Johnny Cueto. I'm quite looking forward to seeing Johnny Cueto come back. Another rookie there, Adbert Alzolay. Yeah, looking forward to Cueto coming back. He's got some wicked movement on his changeup. Chris Paddock, the sheriff, is going to be starting for the Padres against the Diamondbacks. So him versus Bumgarner, two pitchers who get very fired up. Hoping to see lots of home runs pulled off the Arizona lefty. That's a Orbit, the Astros mascot. Nico Goodrum and nice Yordan Alvarez, the kind of rookie card that everyone was looking to pull out of opening day and out of Series 1. let's keep him to one side. Joey Votto and Gregory Polanco. So, it seems weird, Victor Robles in 2020 having his rookie cup card. Let's keep him moving. Ah, nice, one of the sticker collection. These are cool. Pete Alonso of the Mets. Hoping to get a few of these sticker collection. I think they're pretty cool. Not sure who the opening day star is going to be for the New York Mets at this point. I mean, they got quite a few decent guys, but they're going to have a tough time up against Atlanta. Mondesi, Aristides Aquino. Obviously, when this set came out, Aquino was looking like a hotter property, but the Reds fans that I know were telling me he had a bad September, he's had a bad spring training. He's an older guy as well, because he is 94? That makes him, yeah, late 20s. So he, again, definitely into his late 20s. Makes him an older guy anyway. So, you know, if he's going to refine his approach at the plate, stop striking out so much, it's going to have to be a quick transition. Chapman, Jose Ramirez, and Baseball Card Day. Okay, and we've got our last few here for our first blaster box. So there's team tradition cards, Eugenio Suarez, Anthony Rendon. Looks like Rendon is going to be missing the start of the season as well. I think it was an oblique strain, but you know, the Angels will need him if they're going to get into the playoffs like they've been hoping. Jorge Alfaro. Oh, I'm really looking forward to seeing the Twins opening day against the White Sox. I mean, the thing is, it's Berrios and Giolito, so hitting could be hard, could be tough, but obviously everyone's so excited to see all the guys on that White Sox rotation. Obviously, Robert and the Twins last year just put up loads, so many home runs. I'm fairly sure they led baseball. John Means was supposed to start, but he's got arm fatigue just before the short season. He's got arm fatigue, so unfortunately they've had to take him out, and Malone is going to be starting for them. Marco Gonzalez, so Frankie Lindor, and nice little Vladdy Jr. cup card, and our first of these 2020 opening day cards is Eloy Jimenez, which is nice to get that on a rookie cup card. I'll be keeping that one to one side. I was thinking getting this all out, that I wouldn't be surprised if we saw the opening day parallels, these light blue parallels, if we saw them come back in update, because update they're going to be really struggling for different sets. And I just think, you know, we've got this March 26th, 2020. I wouldn't be surprised if they wanted to put in one with the actual opening day that we've ended up with. So I reckon we could see that in our update that's coming. So, second blaster box. We've got Trey Turner of the World Series winning Washington Nationals. Carlos Santana, Jeff McNeil, Juan Soto. Okay, Mike Trout. He'll be hoping that Anthony Rendon can get back as quickly as possible. George Brett. Okay. Eduardo Rodriguez. I'm pretty sure he's still on the IL. Ronald Acuna Jr. Dansby Swanson. Michael Chavis. And Zach Greinke not getting the start for the Astros. Obviously, they're going to be going with Verlander, who's going to be starting against Marco Gonzalez for the Mariners. Nice. So our second opening day parallel is Francisco Lindor. They're kind of like a little bonus, aren't they, these opening day ones? And you get them with guys you like. That's a nice thing. Okay, opening day, stadiums there. We've got, that was the Dodgers, Jameson Taillon. Our second Sean Doolittle, and our second Vogelbach. Seems like we've got a little print run there. Clive, Nick Senzel, Yuan Moncada. If someone's going to keep up their batting average, their batting statistics in this short season where it's tricky to get started, you'd think it might be Yuan Moncada. Fred Bird of the Cardinals. Stick you over there. Paul DeJong. Sandy Alcantara, like I think I mentioned, starting for the Marlins on opening day. They're opening on Friday or early Saturday morning here. Ian Kennedy. Trent Grisham, rookie for the Padres. Eduard Olivares might actually knock one of those original Padres, you know, sort of expected stars out, because he's apparently been doing really, really well, which is awesome to see, because he's always been a kind of a favorite of mine going up through the minors of the Padres. Okay, Austin Riley, my guy. Brandon Lowe. Luke Voigt and the Cincinnati Reds. We've got Rhys Hoskins, Starling Marte. Rhys Hoskins has got an awesome moment. Very, very cool mustache. Lance Lynn, he's getting the start in the post-Kluber against the Rockies. Clayton Kershaw, Abraham Toro, number two. Tatis, Mike Fiers. Good guy. Framil Reyes. And then we've got the Toronto Blue Jays. This stadium will not be used. The Buffalo Blue Jays, I don't think we've fully established where it's going to be, because it could be in Pittsburgh. They suggested that they would like to host the Blue Jays. So, yeah, we'll see. Great stadium if you're going to choose another one to be in. And Jack Flaherty. thinking when we get to 100 subs, there's a little bit of a celebration. Might be going looking for that Jack Flaherty Chrome first. So stay posted for that one. Sec, please, sec. Paxton, Eduardo Escobar, Screech. Okay, Joey Votto, Chris Paddock, Judge. That where they left in the starter for Judge to for like a fourth out, because you know obviously the summer games that just get everyone tuned up, and as with as the day before, I think the day before he'd hit two home runs and he absolutely crushed one. Mitch Garver, oh, and a second George Brett. Aristides Aquino. Yordan Alvarez, number two. Eloy Jimenez. Rookie Cup. Cody Bellinger. So, hopefully we'll see that Luis Robert pop up, that short print. Another sticker. Anthony Rendon. And we're coming to the end here. Adalberto Mondesi. Luis Castillo, who's not getting the first start for the Reds. I think that's going to be Sonny Gray, actually. Oscar Mercado, Luis, Lucas Giolito, and the Monument Garden at the Atlanta Braves. That's going to be it for opening day for us. I hope you all really enjoy opening day. I'd be interested to hear what kind of things you guys are going to be up to enjoy it, to make a little celebration of it, because I'm sure, like me, you're all just glad that it's here and that we're going to have it. So take care, and I'll see you on the next one.